This week's Ask Dr. Durie is from a questioner that really has a very insightful question. This gentleman points out that we talk about patients who have good and bad risk features, where patients with what we call bad risk features have abnormal chromosomes, whereas the good risk patients have normal chromosomes. What he points out and asks a question about is, well, if the patients with myeloma with good risk have normal chromosomes, why do they have myeloma? Isn't myeloma caused by chromosome damage? And this is, as I say, very insightful and points to the fact, which is frequently ignored, is that the types of chromosome damage that actually lead to the development of myeloma are actually much more subtle than the major jumping around of chromosomes that we point to in our FISH testing, where the 414 chromosome change, where chromosome 4 gets linked up with chromosome 14. These are major jumping arounds of chromosomes, but if one nucleotide in the DNA, what we call a point mutation, has occurred because of exposure to the DNA to some toxic chemical in the environment, this is not going to be immediately obvious in our routine chromosome testing. And so the questioner is exactly correct that there are areas of chromosome damage. We do not pick them up with our normal testing. And these are possibly the more important chromosome damage effects, which we need to know about, we need to understand, and link back to what is causing the chromosome damage. We do know that certain types of chemicals, for example, petrochemicals, things like solvents and fire retardants and different types of chemicals that we run into in the environment, not only can they damage the DNA, but they create what is called a characteristic fingerprint. And so you can tell that the DNA has in fact been damaged by a particular type of chemical. And so the bottom line for this question is very insightful, very important damage which can be causing myeloma that we're not picking up routinely, and that we are just beginning to understand what these types of damage may be, and they indeed may be the driving mutations which are leading the disease forward and which we need to know about and to perhaps block or reverse in such a way that we can more fully control the disease and understand the disease and do a better job in diagnosing and managing multiple myeloma. So thank you. A very important question this week.